Barcelona, Spain AP politics and soccer will merge on Sunday when Barcelona become more than just a football club for Catalonia. Separatist Barcelona's home match against Las Palmas fall on the day when the region secessionist leader have vowed to defy authority and hold a disputed referendum on independence from Spain. The Spanish government called the vote illegal and has ordered a crackdown to stop any ballot from being cast, sparking protest in the street and university. The dispute has increased tension in the proud and prosperous region to Fever Peak, and Barcelona's Camp Nou Stadium will be no exception. It won't be a normal day. It will be a historic day for the country, but we have to treat the football match like any other. Barcelona Vice President Jordi Cardona said we will carry the Catalan flag red and yellow color on the collar of our shirt and in our heart. Europe's largest stadium at nearly 100,000 seats, Camp Nou has become a rallying point for Catalan nationalists in recent years with the boom in support for a break from Spain that also has reached roughly half of the region's 7.5 million residents. Spain King Felipe V met with deafening jeer Camp Nou at the final of the Copa del Rey in 2015, and the chant of independence that are a fixed feature of every home match are set to be at maximum volume come Sunday. Given the supercharged atmosphere, the club has called for calm and for the spirit of sport to prevail. We are not uncomfortable with the date of the match. It's an important day for Catalonia, and the interests of Barca have to be compatible with the majority of Catalan. Các donor said he believe that each one of our member and fan can express whatever they want, but we ask them to do it respectfully. We are focusing on the competition. We want to win the match. Barcelona defender Gerard Piqué is also giving you advice. From today until Sunday, we will express ourselves pacifically. Piqué tweeted on Thursday, don't give them any excuse for a crackdown. That's what they want, and sing loud and clear. Piqué and the rest of Barcelona's players have good reason not to get distracted by the ruin of politics and police activity. The team is on an 8-game winning run, led the league and held a 7-point advantage over his rival Real Madrid in 6 play. Barcelona's football club became identified as a bastion of Catalan culture during the repressive year of Gen Francisco Franco's dictatorship from 19,391,970. When the Catalan language which is spoken alongside Spanish was banned from school and public use, its slogan more than a club has come to mean for many is commitment to Catalonia. In the past 4 decades, Catalonia has gained a large degree of self-governance and boasts one of the strongest economy of the southern European country. Still, many Catalans feel disrespected by the central government in Madrid and complain that they pay more in taxes than they receive back in public spending. Barcelona's rivalry with Real Madrid carry political overtone for many, with Barça representing Catalonia and Real Madrid standing in for the rest of Spain. Most of Barcelona's players avoid talking about politics, but former player and coach Pep Guardiola has led pro-independent rally and is an outspoken proponent of Sunday vote. This in about independence, it's about democracy. Guardiola, the Manchester City manager, said in a video posted on social media by a separatist grassroots group this week, Barcelona has openly backed a referendum and criticized the robust step taken by authority to impede the vote that Spain government consider unconstitutional, sin question of state should involve all Spania, not just those in one region. Many Catalan are lukewarm supporters at best of Spain national team, which would lose several key players including Piqué, Sergio Busquets and Jordi Alba if Catalonia separated. Catalonia already had a regional selection that played the occasional friendly. It got a huge boost when it was coached by that great Johan Cruyff, and it has played top-level national side including Argentina and Brazil. Police have decreased the chances of separatists being able to hold a wide scan vote with Brownian party have boycotted on ground that it is outside the law and lacking in guarantee of transparency. But Barcelona's alignment with the separatist cause is in direct conflict with its desire to remain one of the world's most successful soccer team. Not only would Barcelona join the rise of alienating supporter across Spain, the big three is the potential fly of its top star, led by Lionel Messi, Spanish league president Javier Tebas and Spain's higher council of sport have repeatedly warned that Barcelona and the other football club in Catalonia would be out of La Liga if the region succeeded. Tebas recently said that Barcelona would be in a Catalan division that would be much better than the Dutch league. Real Madrid are already the two-time defending UEFA Champions League winner and a top as one of two or three favorite to be crowned champion of Europe again this season. More Carlo Ancelotti out Bayern Munich manager why the past three Champions League triumph in four seasons is already littered with silverware. The future in looking so bad either after the defending La Liga champion announced new long-term contract for a pair of under 25 superstar in the making in the span of 24 hours this week. 24-year-old defender Rafael Varane, who featured prominently in O3 UCL run, signed on Wednesday a new 5-year deal it will keep him at the club until 2022. A day later, 21-year-old attacker Marco Asensio loudly announced himself onto the world stage on ready this season. The update for 6 more years with a new deal tying him to Los Blancos until 2023. More sound get refreshingly honest about England lack of quality Asensio signed for Madrid from Mallorca in the summer of 2014, but spend the next 2 seasons on loan back at his old club for a season and then at Espanyol. Last season saw him break into the first team and flash momentary bit of brilliant late on in the season. That momentum has carried over to this season as the heir apparent to the trio of Cristiano Ronaldo, Gareth Bale and Karim Benzema has 4 goals and 1 assist through the first 10 games of competition. To the surprise of absolutely no one, Real Madrid will remain quite good for quite some time to come. Follow a cổng ANDYEDMLS Colorado Rapid forward Kevin Doyle said he is retiring because of repeated concussion. Doyle is from Ireland and has played 16 years in Europe and in Major League Soccer. He released a statement via social media Thursday. This year it has been clear to me that heading the ball was becoming problematic and causing me to have repeated headaches. Doyle wrote full statement here. 2 concussions this season and numerous other over the year have made this more concerning. Doyle said after consulting with Dr. He decided to retire rather than risk permanent damage. The 34-year-old has 16 goals and 8 assists in 71 matches with the Rapid since joining the team in 2015. Before that he played 10 years in Europe, including stint with the Wolverhampton Wanderers, Queen Park Rangers and Crystal Palace. He was also a regular with the Irish national team, making 63 appearances and scoring 14 goals in Premier League and proud to have fulfilled my childhood dream of playing for my country. Doyle wrote everything else was a bonus. Doyle latest concussion came on set high again LA Galaxy and he had played since. He had 5 goals and 4 assists in 25 matches this season. Kevin is both a terrific player and a terrific person, said Rapid interim general manager Patrick Smith said in a statement. His contribution on the field has been invaluable and off the hard field he has been a wonderful influence on the locker room as well as the community as a whole. His effort it will be so limit former MLS standard and current broadcaster Taylor Twoman, who was forced to retire from soccer because of concussion, posted a message to Doyle on Twitter. The Rapid have struggled this season and were eliminated from playoff contention Wednesday night with a 20 loss at Dallas following this weekend's later Premier League fixture. Club soccer will take another break for 5 months. Thus, the midday portion of the season is so nearly upon us. First, though, one more round of league game followed by that dreaded weekend of WSPL Prediction TV. Team schedule for the weekend. Here are 5 of the biggest PL storyline to follow over the next 72 hours. First of 6 battle among the Big 3 if we're operating under the widespread notion that Manchester City, Manchester United and Chelsea, as they currently sit 1-2-3 in the league table, are the main contender for this season PL title. Saturday 12:30 p.m. ET kick-off at Stamford Bridge Online on NBC SNN NBC SPORTS. com is a massive important Baadi versus Muston Man City 212 combined score through 6 games like Man United I yet to lose a game in the PL this season while Chelsea have lost since opening day 102 combined score in the ensuing 5 games to say Antonio Conte and Pep Guardiola say are in good form would be quite the understatement. Conte got the better of Guardiola on both occasions last season, knocking Anine Man City side at the Etihad Stadium in December before doing the double with a 21 win at home in April. Excite was victorious in the UEFA Champions League this week with City Racing, Shakhtar Donetsk side and Chelsea snatching a 3 points from their away trip to Atletico Madrid. Undefeated versus only defeated 5 win, 1 draw. Man United start on the season 0 win, 0 draw, 6 losses. Crystal Palace start on the season. Unfortunately for Frank de Boer, Roy Hodgson up next for the Eagles is a trip to Old Trafford followed by a visit from Chelsea. So expecting to get worse before they get better. Will Palace score their first goal this season turn into five-out, further complicating matter for Hodgson and co. Is the scintillating former Romelu Lukaku 9 goal in 8 game or competition and the an attacking duo of Marcus Rashford and Anthony Martial 10 goal between them all competition already this season. Even with Paul Pogba still unavailable through injury hamstring, Jose Mourinho's men did the double over Palace last season, winning 21 away in December and cruising to a 20 victory at home in May. Rafa faces his former club Rafa Benitez of 6 seasons as manager at Anfield and I had previously faced his former club as manager of Chelsea. Sunday 1130 AM ET kick-off live on NBC SNN NBC SPORTS. com will be just the second time has done so I at Newcastle United. Why is still early in the season, the Magpie current standing in the league table 9th and they trail the Red by just 2 points. It is undoubtedly one of the biggest surprises thus far. Northside currently in the top 16 of the league table has conceded more goals than Liverpool, which is welcome new for a Newcastle side that has struggled a fair bit in the goal scoring department 6 in 6 games. On the other hand, nothing tips in thus far will have prepared them for the allowed attacking onslaught Liverpool are set to unleash trouble ahead for Huddersfield. Huddersfield were the single biggest story in the PL through 2 games. 2 win as a newly promoted side had them level on point for the league lead, though David Wayner side has come back down to earth in its last 4 games. 3 draw and a loss which slot them into 8th player. Head of Saturday visit from Tottenham Hotspur 730 AM ET, Spotlight on BCSN and NBC SPORTS. com is the first time the Terrier have played any of the PLS Big Six and signal the start of a run of five-year game against those very side, Man United, Liverpool, Man City and Arsenal overall in relatively quick succession. Battle at the bottom leaderboard places 15 through 19 currently read as follows: Swansea, Stoke City, Leicester, West Ham and Bournemouth. Why is too early to call any game a relegation sponsor? It's far from too early to preclude yourself from the relegation dogfight. It will be cultivated over the following 2 months. Follow a cộng ANDYEDMLS Gareth Southgate England has a bizarrely positive crowded feel about it this day. And must have that belief center around the 47-year-old manager refreshingly honest nature of management and speaking to the press more England 26 man roster for final World Cup qualifier. Why there was serious question day over whether or not Southgate truly wanted the job, at least at the time he was put in sack. It would appear his presence has provided the Terry Lion that much need healthy dose of reality and grounding. Take for example his comment on Thursday in which he bemoaned the lack of fit option available to him and does everything but name in saying I had to go in player that don't belong here right now. Quote from the Guardian is frustrating because the biggest story here is we have about 12 player missing with injury. It's incredible. If you were to say I'm entirely happy with the squad I named tenor because I've got too many good player missing with injury and the consequence of that you could well argue is that they are one or two in the squad who have unnecessarily warranted it on their performances. The reality is that you don't want player to be comfortable. He said the danger when you don't have competition for places is to fail what the level need the target in the squad and is everyone fulfilling that at the moment. While I'm not so sure they are, there has been a couple of easy decisions because you haven't had to make any phone call to player who might feel had done by, they are on a difficult phone call to make, but it rather be making them. After that we come into training and it's am I sure and to get in the team or so I have to put a bit harder because I have a couple snapping at me. The rest a good challenge for those player in the next week if they want to stay in the squad even without the full complement of player head have preferred to go into game for next week final pair of World Cup qualifier against Slovenia and Lithuania. Southgate still has the inform line of Harry Kane, Marcus Rashford, Raheem Sterling and Dele Alli to full back up on as England need just 2 more points to secure automatic qualification to next summer tournament in Russia. The wire around England feels at least from afar to be better at present than it has done in a long time, especially at any point being 9 months ahead of a major international tournament. Follow a cộng ANDYEDMLS.